So I look on the internet. Finally, we got off it. Shut up. Okay. What the? You watch SMG4 crap? Yeah. What do you want me to do? I want you to please, can you actually, watch them? Oh, you've got to be kidding me. You want to watch some Mr. Beast videos? Okay, Mr. Beast. Ooh, hardcore. There we go. Skit. Raid Shadow Legends is absolutely bad. I hate these. Please get out. Oh my god, I hate computers. That's why I didn't buy one.
Sleep on day 24 which means I woke up.
I am now a quarter of the way done!
Oh, what is that?
Oh, spawner.
That's big, big. This spawner is just below my base, which means later on I can use it as an XP farm.
Rotten flesh, thank you for that. You're probably wondering, Mr. Beast, you just spent like a trillion days mining. That is correct, and the fruit of my labor is in this chest. Look at all this redstone. Stacks on stacks of iron, lapis, gold. This is glorious and will allow us to do tons of cool stuff.
On day 28, a trader came to my house and attempted to scam me.
Black dye, seeds, pumpkin seeds. Bring good trades next time, idiot.
And on days 29 and 30, I started gathering materials to build an enchantment table.
Now we need to make a book.
Bada boom, bada bang, boom.
Hey, horse! I'm an enchantment table!
And now we need tons of books, which require paper and leather. On day 32, Carl texted me that he was bored, so I told him to hop on Minecraft and join us.
Carl! Welcome to the world!
Hey!
So, Carl, it is currently day number 32 of 100.
Jesus!
Right over here is our house on a house on a house.
This is terrible!
Just for that?
Ah! Wait, if I die, I'm out!
Are you serious?
I forgot. I'm not the only one on hardcore. Carl and I spent all of day 32 and 33 leveling my base.
Yeah! Digging, baby!
Yes, I called a friend to come help me level my base.
And as you can see, the lands are flatter than ever.
Day 33 came to an end, and on day 34, Carl made a landmark discovery.
It's a sand tunnel. It could have, like, a lot of good stuff.
I'm coming!
But while we started traveling to the desert temple, we realized it was getting dark.
Oh, we shouldn't be out here. Oh god, hurry! Wait, let's go to the village! And then sleep in the beds of the village.
Okay, where's the village?
There's a creeper! Oh god, there's skeletons!
Get out of the bed! We finally made it to the village safely and slept for one night. Finally, it's time for me and Carl to risk our dumb lives by going into the desert temple.
Dig down here, and then just destroy the pressure plate. Destroy it.
There, you happy? Mom?
Now we can see what's in here.
Oh, golden apple. This is my, like, safety net.
And after getting the treasure, we made our way back to the base.
Before I can relieve you of your duties, I need you to help me build milk shelves around this thing.
Woo! Let's do it! You kept bone meal sugar cane? I have 34 sugar cane and counting.
Yeah, I have 8.
So on day 36, we made the sugar cane into paper and a bunch of leather from the cows on my farm.
Cha-ching, cha-chow, kapow. Moment of truth, Carl. I put the pickaxe in, put the lapis in. Level 30, what do I get? Efficiency 4, silk touch, and unbreaking 3.
That's pretty nice.
I enchanted my iron armor for the time being, and finally on day 37, it was time to say goodbye to Carl.
Carl, buddy, thank you for coming out.
Bye, Jimmy!
I wasn't alone for too long, though, because on day 38, Chris joined to help out.
Chris!
Yeah?
Welcome to the world!
Today's day 38.
Chris didn't know this, but I had big plans for him to help me out in the nether. Things are gonna get a little crazy.
If I die, it's 100% your fault.
There's like 100 pigmen in a hole right here.
Yo, there's 3 of these.
Oh, I don't have gold on! Oh, crap, I forgot if you don't have gold on. Ah!
Jimmy, let me back in!
Yo,
get in!
Chris put gold boots out so the piglins didn't attack him. And we got to work making the base of the nether more secure.
But as you can see, there are some holes.
Ah! What?
He shoots the hole!
We're still building! I'm at half health from that and I have full armor on.
Oh my god, I don't care about it.
Oh, one shot.
I wish I could edit it out.
Just wanted to kill us.
Chris, watch out. Big piggy.
I'm on full sand. Oh god. Damn it.
Everything was trying to end this hardcore run, even Chris himself.
Chris! I'm actively building!
Chris must have forgot that if I die, the world gets deleted forever.
Oh god. Ah! I can't sprint!
Don't mind me, just mining glowstone above a giant pole of lava. I can't. My hands are sweating. Get me off here.
Chris and I agreed that it was best to get back home ASAP before we dived in the nether. Once we got back, we spent all of day 42 setting up the glowstone around the house. And on day 43, Chandler joined. Before I even thought about going back to the nether, I desperately needed diamond armor. So me and the boys hit the mine.
Whichever one of you finds the most diamonds in the next 3 Minecraft days, I'll give you a firm handshake.
All right, let's go.
And while the boys are collecting diamonds, I need to find a way to get more levels.
As the boys mined, I went back to the spawner beneath my base. Chris gave up on mining and became allergic to the nether. But on day 47, everything that could go wrong went wrong.
Skeleton!
Chandler was surrounded by mobs. And Chris kept making mistakes with lava in the nether.
Wow, lava spreads way farther. I might die.
Don't die, Chris.
Oh, I'm good.
And on day 48, minutes after Chris's recent mistake, well, just play the clip.
You had one job, Chris.
I was trying to make it look really pretty, and I was focused.
Get away from me! Everything's just going wrong since you walked in the room.
Hey, Chandler.
Hey.
It is now officially day 50. I'm halfway done!
Woo! You want to stick the next 50 days out with me?
Nope.
Bye.
On day 50 when I logged in, and my chickens were everywhere. Where did these chickens come from? So I spent the entire day gathering them back into my farm. Days 52 and 53 was just a bunch of organizing. And on day 54, I built a minecart track to the mines.
It works very well.
Awesome. Now that we've crossed 50 days, it's time to get serious about leveling up. I needed to not only upgrade my weapons, but also needed to set up an XP farm to get OP enchanted materials.
Diamond chestplate.
Protection 4!
I'm not dying now.
After enchanting my diamond chestplate on day 58, I went to finish my XP farm so I can enchant more armor. But nothing was working to keep the mobs dying in the same spot.
They can still get through! What?
I even watched a bunch of YouTube tutorials, but
I want to have some fun real quick.
Nothing was cutting it.
Today is day 69, the day I conquer the spider spawner. I hope. Funny number.
And after 11 whole days, I finally got a working XP farm.
It works! It finally worked! Oh my gosh, there's so many spiders!
So I went back to the base, and on day 70, I tested my hard work by enchanting a pickaxe.
Yes! Fortune 3! Now I can use this when I find diamonds to get more diamonds!
With fortune on my side, it's time for a few days of diamond hunting.
Diamonds!
We have this fortune pick.
4!
I mined 5 diamonds and got 16 diamonds. That sentence didn't make much sense. But even with a Fortune 3 pickaxe, luck isn't always on our side.
Oh no!
Was that literally just one diamond? And going to sleep on day 74 means that we're 3/4 of the way done!
No.
I found some diamond pants and tested my luck more by enchanting them.
Bada boom, bada bang, ka-check.
My luck was running pretty dry at this point. On day 81, I decided to build a new base because it kept bugging me that Carl said my current base was ugly. And boom! The house is done. I feel like I cheated on my beautiful house over here. It's gotta go. And I ended up not liking my new base, so I blew it up. We'll put one right here, just for fun. Should probably leave. Goodbye, house. I missed one.
Hey, what's going on over here?
Oh! Oh, no, wait! This is hardcore! Now you can't respawn!
I see that now.
Techno died immediately because he didn't know this was a hardcore run. Thankfully, his brother had an alt account.
Take 2. I am a new person that is not Technoblade.
I'm tired of this house, so now we need to build another house on top of it.
I'm down.
For real, we only have 16 days left. Let's keep the building. Techno and I spent all of day 84 building another story on my base.
Oh, that looks pretty good.
But then I realized there wasn't an easy way to get down, so I did this.
So you're telling me if I jump off right now, I will not die?
If I die, that means I have to literally restart 15 hours of work. Whew! It looks like I'm on a roll surviving risky decisions. Because of that, Techno and I prepared to go into the Nether to get some Ender Pearls and Blaze Rods. We wanted to defeat the Ender Dragon.
Techno, brother, we're about to enter the Nether.
We should make a shield first.
Shield these nuts, let's go!
Okay.
So if I fall, I just instantly throw this?
Take your time to throw it.
Oh, I just quit.
When I said take your time,
my hands are so sweaty.
Oh my god. Shut the fuck up.
I decided to ask him some really important questions. Have you ever tried a Mr. Beast burger?
I have not.
No, come back. I can check on DoorDash, Mr. Beast. Come back.
Despite Techno not answering the question, right? Because everyone should order a Beast burger. We're on day 90. It is officially day 90, which means we only have 10 days left.
That's how math works.
I hate him. And on this day, after 3 whole days of searching, we finally found a Nether fortress.
Speed bridge time. Speed bridge. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh no. No. Techno. Techno luckily had a fire resistant potion, but it was his only one.
I don't learn from my mistakes. Let's go.
Is that a skeleton? Not even a flinch.
Well, there's no way an actual skeleton is out here in the middle of the lava.
Oh my god, there's actually a skeleton here.
Yo.
Got your back.
Oh my god. Oh god. I'm dead. It's over.
No, you just left me in the middle of the Nether? You were my
Guardian. So I let Techno's brother's brother join with a different account. Totally not still Technoblade.
Alright, I've changed my skin. No one will know I'm Technoblade.
Well, now I have to journey back across the Fire Lake without Fire Res.
Maybe you should wait for me to get there.
Nope, already doing it. I really shouldn't have booked it without Techno. Because I've literally poured dozens of hours into this video already, and if I died, it was all for nothing. Techno and I met back up, and with only 5 days left, we realized there was no way we could beat the Ender Dragon in time.
I do have a nice compromise, Mr. Beast. This is a baby, and this is a clip.
Say no more.
Sacrifice.
Bye. Oh, wait, oh, it's Mom's
enemy. Oh, my God, it's Mom. It's Mom.
Oh, she did not like that. She did not like that. So we just went to bed and woke back up on day 96. It's day 96.
Yo.
Guys, you don't even understand. I've been playing on this world for over 20 hours.
I don't know. It hasn't seemed that long to me.
Maybe it's because you just joined.
I think my willpower is just stronger.
And these last few days were honestly the hardest part of the challenge. I was dying for it to be over. Doors in a field, doors in a field, doors in a field. Time to sleep! This is me sleeping on day 98, which means it's now day 99, the last day of this entire series. Techno! It's the final day of the series!
We're almost free.
You're actually free to leave at literally any point.
Oh, sick, I'm out.
Techno and I built a memorial, crafted a cake, made a table, and waited for the sun to set on this glorious day. Techno has his horse, we have our cake, the sun is winding down. The only thing missing is the chickens. Come here, chickens. Join us! Join us! I think it's time we end the series.
I think it is, too.
Let's go to bed.
Yo!
It's over! I'm going to bed.